Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video I'm going to share my vector coloring process in Affinity Designer. Alright, so I've got my tiger line art here, and what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to create a layer underneath my line art. I just drag this layer right under the line art. I'm going to grab my pen tool. And I'm going to start recreating the outline of the tiger, and then this will then act as my fill shape. If you created the tiger using a stroke for the outline, you'd simply be able to come up here and select your fill color for that shape. I used the fill method to create these lines in order to get a more stylized look, especially to some of the hairs here. Get a sharper, nicer point when you use the fill method. I'll have a link in the description on my video for stroke versus fill. Kind of breaks down different ways of approaching line art in vector. So I'm just going to go ahead and continue working around. We'll speed this up here just a little bit. Here, you can go ahead and what I typically do is I will make half of the shape here. You can go ahead and create the rest of the outline if you'd like. For this, I'll go ahead and just select a nice orange for now. I'm going to select my move tool. And I will simply hold Alt and Shift, which will duplicate and then keep that selection in line. I'll come up here and flip horizontal. Continuing to hold shift, I'll drag the rest of that fill shape over. I'm gonna come in here, I'll line up my nodes. We'll then select both shapes and add. Now creating one full shape here. Alright, so I've got the white fur of the tiger in here. I just simply came in and did my fill outline. After I was done with one side, I mirrored and duplicated it to the other side. And now what we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to continue adding our flat base colors to the rest of the elements of the tiger. So for instance, down here in the mouth, one of the things that I like to do is I like to work from the main background shape forward. So for instance, down here in the mouth, I'm going to go ahead and start. I'm going to turn off snapping for now. And I want to get the main mouth color first, and then I can add the teeth and tongue on top. Pick somewhat of a gray for this, maybe lean in a little bit more towards the red, something like that will look pretty good. I'm going to drag this down to our main color layer here. Alright, so you see we've got that in there pretty nice. Moving to my move tool, Alt and Shift in order to duplicate and keep in place. And we'll come in here and line these nodes up. I could select and combine both of these shapes if I'd like. And, make that one big shape. And this will come in handy later. I'm going to continue working on these shapes here, so we'll go ahead and continue with the tongue. And these color layers are again below my line art layer. The alternative method would be to, if you took this tongue shape, you could just fill it if you'd like. I like to keep my colors separate from my line art when I'm doing illustrations like this. There are certain times where I will just add them together, but it's for a specific purpose. And we're just going to continue to work each individual element. I am adding these shapes together as I complete them. It's often helpful to have these, especially since I'm doing half the shape at once, combining both halves so that way it's one shape, and when we want to go and manipulate it with color later, we'll be able to do that easily if we want to add gradients or such. The process could seem a little tedious at first, but I promise the more you work with the nodes and get used to vector, the faster the process will become. I think I want the inside of his mouth to be just a little bit darker, so we'll just select that shape, come back in here to our color, actually maybe even make it just a little more. There we go, something a little more like that. And just a few more of the elements here. We've got his nose, and then his eyeballs. Tigers didn't have this nice kind of pink little nose. Just kind of funny when you consider how ferocious they are, right? Just walking around with that pink little nose. Alright, we'll come up here to the eyes and we're going to add the white area of the eye, and then we'll add the colors of the pupil as well. Now for the tiger's pupils, they're typically going to add a slight greenish. I'm going to add a little bit of a gradient to the eye. It's kind of got this outside yellow ring. Should reverse that. Alt and Shift to duplicate and keep in line. Alright, and there we go. We've got our flat base colors all set and ready to go in vector. So with these base colors here, this could be good enough for certain applications if you simply need just one color print on something in particular. But one way that we can go ahead and really make this pop without having to go too crazy or add too much to it is we can use gradients. So I'm going to go ahead and start with the orange fur of the tiger. Select my gradient tool and just pull out to give myself some base gradient to work with here. I'll come up here to the color window where I could further manipulate the gradient. I have a video on gradients, which I'll link in the description below. When it comes to faces and heads, I typically like to use the radial. Heads are very round and spherical, so I think the radial gradient really helps emphasize and add to that. So let's see. kind of pull this up here where I want my main light source to kind of be hitting from above. So the light's kind of going to be hitting the top of his head and then coming down. Now what we can also do is we can add two additional points, medium dark, medium light, and I'm going to kind of switch them around a little bit. So what this will allow us to do is messing with the radial gradient. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and lighten these ones just a little bit more, a little closer to yellow, so we could see that difference a little more. Okay. So now you can see that radial gradient. As I push and move this, you can see that light and dark move. So basically what I want here, and what I'm going for, is I want light to be at the top of his head. I want there to be a little darkness right around the eyes. That's a pretty deep, dark area for shadows and whatnot. And then we'll have this light at the top of the nose. I'll just bump up and move these around a little bit. See how you can manipulate these gradients. Just keep playing around with it. Something like this, I think, is working pretty good. So with this gradient in place, you can see we have a clear light area, transitions to a more dark area between the eyes, and then the nose, which is going to be catching a bunch of that light again. So that is typically how I'll set up a gradient for a head or face. And then we can come into the other elements and do something very similar. So for the tongue, we could stick with more of a linear gradient. You can feel that it's receding into the tiger's mouth. And the same for this. But you can see how much it really starts adding to the depth of the overall image. Play with the colors a little bit more. Some of the light's a little lighter, dark's a little darker. You can even see what we think about maybe adding some variety to the whites of the fur as well. I'm just gonna gray this up a little bit. Again, it doesn't have to be too harsh. And it's something that you could play around with to get the look that you like. You can add gradients to certain things. You can leave the gradients off of other elements to create some contrast. And just working through these elements a little bit, just throwing some basic gradients on here just to give you an idea of what you can do. Alright, so right off the bat there, just simply adding those gradients to the flat base color really does help out quite a bit. I'll throw some gradient on here real quick, try radial. And there you go. So we've taken our flat base colors, we've added a gradient to them, which has added some light and dark, that light and shadow there, which will create some form. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. Keep chasing your dreams, and until next time.